He's a revered spiritual leader, a member of high society, and a philanthropist funding works across the globe. Today, the Aga Khan visited Canada and left behind a remarkable gift. The CBC's Laurie Graham was there when Canada gave him something in return.
They gathered outside, hoping to catch a peek.
He's the King of Kings, and I just want to have one glimpse, and that will make my day.
Tens of thousands came to this conference center to watch a broadcast of his appearance.
It's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and so we're very fortunate.
Fortunate to see this man, the Aga Khan, spiritual leader of Ismaili Muslims around the world.
It also means a great deal to me that all of you can be here today.
The Aga Khan has long admired Canada, ever since it opened its borders to thousands of displaced Ismailis expelled from Uganda in the 70s. Today, he came to Canada to unveil the plans for a multi-million dollar Islamic museum and cultural center, mostly paid for by his foundation.
We believe the museum will help address what is not so much a clash of civilizations as it is a clash of ignorances.
Prime Minister Stephen Harper accepted the gift and offered one of his own, honorary Canadian citizenship.
There are no superlatives to adequately describe the admiration Canadians have for your work, that you and your organization do for us all in the service of pluralism, peace, and development around the world.
There are about 70,000 Ismailis living in Canada, and many here felt proud their spiritual leader is now Canadian too.
The values that he talks about, the values talks about us living together in peace, in harmony, tolerance of other people, tolerance of other ethnicities, I think is great, and he speaks well of those values of Canada.
The museum will open in 3 years, and it will be the first in North America solely devoted to Islamic art and history. But Ismaili Muslims are hoping the center will attract people of all religions and backgrounds. Laurie Graham, CBC News, Toronto.